పరస్పర వివాదాల వల్లే దక్షిణాది నేతలు జాతీయ రాజకీయాల్లో రాణించలేకపోతున్నారని గాంధీజీ మనుమడు రాజ్మోహన్ గాంధీ అభిప్రాయపడ్డారు. ఇకనైనా ఐక్యంగా ఉంటే జాతీయ స్థాయిలో రాణించవచ్చని హితవు పలికారు. కొన్నేళ్లుగా ప్రభుత్వాలు గ్రామాల అభివృద్దిని విస్మరించాయని వెల్లడించారు. దక్షిణాది రాష్ట్రాలపై తాను రచించిన మోడ్రన్ సౌత్ ఇండియా పుస్తకావిష్కరణ కోసం విజయవాడ వచ్చిన రాజ్మోహన్ గాంధీతో ఈటీవీ ముఖాముఖి.
జాతిపిత మహాత్మా గాంధీ మనవడు, ప్రముఖ పుస్తక రచయిత రాజ్మోహన్ గాంధీ మనతో ఉన్నారు. గాంధీజీ మనవడిగా ప్రస్తుత రాజకీయాలపై ఆయనకున్న అభిప్రాయం, పుస్తక రచయితగా పుస్తకాలపై ఆయనకున్న అనుభవాన్ని ఆయన మాటల్లోనే తెలుసుకుందాం. వెల్కమ్ టు విజయవాడ సార్. How are you feeling to visit Vijayawada?
Well, I'm very happy to be here because I know of Gandhiji's very deep connection with Vijayawada, and he had so many wonderful supporters and allies here. And to have my book released at the historic Vijayawada book exhibition is a great pleasure for me.
Is it the first time to visit Vijayawada?
No, I was here in 1963, a long time ago, before you were born and before many of my viewers might have been born. But that was a very short visit.
You have visited Vijayawada after a long time. Yes. Have you seen any something special places here?
Not yet. This is a historic place. It has so many important landmarks. So I expect to spend some time seeing many of these places.
Can you give a brief note about your book?
Yes, this gives an integrated story of South India as a whole. And I'm very glad that I've had a chance to present the South India story to the rest of India and to the world.
Till now, how many books you have written?
I think this is my book number 14, 1-4.
As a writer, can you tell us the importance of a book?
People don't make time to read a book. But what a book can convey to a human being, to a young person, to a middle-aged person, to an old person, cannot be conveyed by the internet or by television. It means that you don't expect that knowledge will come to you in 5 seconds. Knowledge to enter one's mind and one's heart has to be acquired through patient study. You can create your own imagination. Sound bites and videos cannot do.
Nowadays, in this internet world, students are becoming far distant from the books. Can you suggest them to fill that gap?
If a student finds a book that he or she loves, there's nothing more precious than that. But books are his friends and companions. And he can create a wonderful life with his companions. So internet is not an enemy of books. But internet is not a substitute for books. The books will have their place.
As a grandson of Mahatma Gandhi, how are you feeling about the present politics?
Freedom came a long time ago. Now we have to face today's problems. And today we have unemployment. We have to recreate life in the villages. All of India can't live in Vijayawada, Hyderabad, Bangalore, Chennai, Bombay, Delhi. So we must create life in the villages.
Regarding politics, so many think about that North Indian politicians will dominate the South India. Do you feel that?
In the past, that has been the story. One of the questions I ask in my book also is, why is it that the South has been reluctant to lead India as a whole? Why have most leaders come from the North? There have been two Southern prime ministers. There was Narasimha Rao, there was Devagowda. But those were in some ways accidental prime ministers.
I think you are aware of present politics. NDA is now ruling. What is the difference between the Congress and NDA?
You know, the Congress ruled until 2014. The NDA has come now. People expected a lot from the NDA government. They expected that unemployment will be tackled. Unfortunately, that has not happened. How to bring employment to the villages, bring jobs and prosperity to the villages is a very difficult task. One government alone cannot do it. But I think now the time has come to make a focus on rural employment, creating new life in the villages. So many people have been neglected in India, not just in the last four or five years, but even in earlier years.
Narendra Modi, after taking the charge as a prime minister, for every project, he's remembering the Mahatma Gandhiji, and he's saying that I'm implementing the ideas of Mahatma Gandhi, like Swachh Bharat and Make in India. Do you think they are working ground level?
Swachh Bharat is a wonderful idea. But Swachh Bharat doesn't only mean removal of physical dirt. It means also removal of anger, removal of hatred. So Swachh Bharat also should mean that every Indian must be interested in fellow Indian. So that aspect of Swachh Bharat has not been emphasized by the present government at all. Mahatma Gandhi's name can be used, but his ideas about equality, about unity, about no hatred and no fear, those are very important values that should be emphasized, have not been emphasized today. Well, you know, this wonderful Sardar Patel statue, it was not made in India. Even Sardar Patel's statue, so much of it was made in China. Make in India is a good concept, but we have to make it a reality. It has not been made a reality.
స్వచ్ఛ భారత్ అంటే కేవలం వీధుల్లోని చెత్తను ఎరువేయడం మాత్రమే కాదని, మనిషిలోని రాగద్వేషాలను తొలగించాలంటున్నారు మహాత్మా గాంధీజీ మనవడు రాజ్మోహన్ గాంధీ. కెమెరామెన్ శేష్ బాబుతో ప్రహల్య మహేష్, ఈటీవీ న్యూస్, విజయవాడ.